creator of the show, and I'm
and
married
the photographer's
to the photographer
name?
Volker Hinz. I'm married to the photographer Volker Hinz.
Mm-hmm. So tell me a bit about this. It's going from the 70s?
Yes, the pictures start, I think, at 77, and the latest are from 2011, which is Lady Gaga.
Mm-hmm.
And the pictures, he did a lot of stories backstage, design designers and photo fashion designers, of, not photo fashion designers, photo fashion designers now, sorry. He did
Don't disappear.
Yeah.
I want to know how the two of, how did the two of you get together to co-curate this?
Okay. He invented Photo Festival Union because mm-hmm. I'm not only doing my husband's work, but I'm also organizing a photo festival in Hamburg, Germany.
Mm-hmm.
And he was inventing of European Photo Festival Union.
Mm-hmm.
So he invited a lot of photo festival directors to Butch, and that's how we got to know each
and
other.
And now we work together because I'm artistic
yes.
director of the Hamburg
Photographic
Triennial. Next
year,
oh,
great. 2015.
So there are two festivals. One is yeah. in Hamburg, one is in Butch, Poland.
Yeah, that's it.
That's great.
Yeah.
And this is the main show. The Volker Hinz exhibition will be open tomorrow. Although the festival is in June, it's starting on 5th of June. But we have 1 month in advance the opening of the Volker Hinz. And he's personally also coming for the opening.
Ah, great.
That's right.
Where is he based now?
In Hamburg.
Okay. And can you show me some of your favorite images, both of you? I know I have one. I love the story. Can you repeat the story about Roman Polanski and your husband?
Oh, I see.
Do you have this picture? Where's Roman Polanski?
It's on
yeah.
the other side.
Do you want me to take it?
Yeah, that would be good.
Okay.
And Hana Shiguya, I dressed her in a film.
This is the... Because this is fashion, this is... the film, and there is the music.
So here we are with
yeah.
Roman Polanski at the police station.
Yes, and around journalists, of course.
Fassbender, my favorite director. The two, that's pretty great. So what happened exactly?
Yeah, this is a funny story too. It was by the end of the 70s. And my husband was at the LA airport and discovered Roman Polanski there waiting for Miss Kinski, the very young Miss Kinski. She was probably 14, 50 by then. And she was accompanied actually by a guy who she later married. This is a kind of an Egyptian boyfriend, and she has two children with him actually. But at that time, Roman Polanski was very much into Natasha Skinsky. And because of the scandal beforehand, because he was into obviously into young girls, and he already was regarded as a, from the American police, he was searched for. Those two guys, my husband as a photographer and a writer, waited there to see how they connect. But Roman Polanski spotted them, and he didn't want to be photographed together with Natasha Kinski. Therefore, he disappeared, and the both journalists followed him and drove through L.A. In a car, and he tried to escape, but it didn't succeed him because my husband was driving very fast too. And then he went to a police station to complain that he is being followed and he doesn't want to be intruded, and there was a big discussion at the police office then, my husband wasn't arrested because he didn't do anything. He even didn't take a proper picture, just from afar. This picture exists, but we didn't take it. So this is a story about the Polanski being, or about the photographer Volker Hinz being a paparazzi for the first and the last time. He usually doesn't do this kind of things. Mostly he makes dates and then he has sittings, and so it's not his job to be a paparazzi, but with Roman Polanski it was different.
And you said he worked many years for Stern magazine.
Yes, he did. Mm-hmm. 35 years altogether. He was a staffer. Yes.
Is there any story behind the Fassbender? It's in the making of the film.
It was behind the scene, and this is actually Fokker. This is it, him, and he makes the photos in a mirror. Oh. So it's him. You see him together with Fassbender. It was backstage on some film set. So I don't have a story behind this.
Give me some.
This is the famous Werner Herzog. He met him in Brazil in the, I'm not quite sure it's Brazil or Bolivia or whatever, when he did his film with Klaus Kinski,
Aguirre,
where they dragged a big ship.
Aguirre, with
a big ship over the mountain.
And the monkeys.
His ship in the background. And this is the Indian boys, because he had a lot of Indians around there, because he had to drag this ship actually over the hill. Only Herzog does this kind of weird thing.
People dying.
Yeah.
And that scene.
And this is on the film set. Yes. And
that scene with the monkeys,
yes.
and Klaus Kinski,
yes.
Is kind of memorable.
That's right.
And Tony Perkins, was that Psycho or
no,
what?
No. This is Harrison Ford.
Oh, Harrison Ford. Yes.
He had just the film Fugitive.
Fugitive.
Yes, and that's why my husband asked him to make it. It was the picture was done in a Hamburg hotel actually, and he asked him to do this kind of a movement as to escape, that it should look like to escape.
But it looks like Tony Perkins in Psycho.
No. It's Harrison Ford.
Show me some of your absolute favorite pictures. I'm sure you have plenty.
Yes,
all of them
right.
Are your babies.
Of course. One of my favorite pictures is Woody Allen.
Mm-hmm.
I actually don't know which film after. Usually the stars come and meet the press before a film.
Mm-hmm.
So this was a film set too, and I remember Fokker telling that he wanted to, in the film obviously this hand, he was being quiet, and he asked Woody Allen to do this move, and he didn't want to. And then he asked twice and three times, and in the end he said, okay, I'm doing it once. So there is only very few shots with this kind of a gesture, which I think is very nice, because it says something about he's kind of shy too. He is not a very outgoing guy in front of the press. So it's very rare that he does something like this.
And in the fashion pictures?
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite?
Oh yes, I think this one, Yves Saint Laurent behind the scene. Did you see the late film of Yves Saint Laurent, which is just out now?
Yes.
And here in the picture you see him, how fragile he somehow is and how very shy he is. He was always very excited before a show, and this is before a show or during a show. And you see he is lying on the floor and watching how the people are looking at his. It's behind a show, and the girls are walking through the wall, and he is looking how the public likes his fashion. So this is a really funny, because you never will see him doing this otherwise. And he was always very nervous before a show. So he was so nervous. So I think this is a very good picture
great.
Of
and
the
Cassius
backstage.
Clay?
This is Muhammad Ali.
Yeah, he has two names.
Cassius Clay and Muhammad Ali, yeah. That's right. My husband visited him in 84 for four 4 days, 3 days in Los Angeles, and one day he accompanied him to Las Vegas. And 48 was a time when he tried his last comeback. So he was after, it was actually after he really was his high time. He probably he needed some money, so he tried to come back. And that's why he is in this rubber gloves, sweating so much. They put a cream on the face, though they get sweating more and more to lose weight, which is very important for a boxer, to lose a lot of weight, so they will be more fit. That's why he's sweating so much. And this is a funny thing. Ali is a guy my husband told me. He's very funny. He always liked to make jokes with everybody. And this face, although it looks very serious and straight, it's just a funny face of his. He likes to make people make him laugh and things like that. That's why he looks so crazy. And my husband said by that time he already showed first signs of his later illness. And that's why he always fell asleep when he was photographed. You can see this in one of his pictures. So this is in his family home. And actually this is one of the daughter became later on a very famous boxer herself.
I didn't know
this,
that.
Lila Clay, I don't know how her name was as a boxer.
Wow.
But she became a very famous boxer. And you see, when he was photographed sitting 5 minutes, he fell asleep. So, and he, my husband said that he already walked a bit like this.
Wow, how old was he then?
84, I don't know how old he was, maybe in his late 30s, something like that.
Oh, it started that early.
Yeah, it's really
scary.
Started.
And was there a picture of William Burroughs, or was I dreaming?
Yes, this was in the front.
This is great. I'm so happy you gave us a preview. Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, it's always good to know. It's good to know more about the pictures than you see it with other eyes, if you know the picture, the stories behind it.
It's much more.
This was in Lawrence, Kansas. There was a reunion of all the beatnik authors and musicians, and my husband photographed a lot of them. He just had them in a show about William Burroughs in Hamburg, and you know the story behind
about
William Burroughs with his wife. So
later on he still liked
to shoot around, like a lot of Americans like to do this. So he had a whole collection of pistols and guns and whatsoever.
He used to leave a pistol under his pillow,
Yeah, he had it everywhere. And because my husband was a photographer,
Thank you.